understand if you have a diode like this, there's a depletion region. This is the junction boundary. This side we had taken P, this is N. So you have negative on this side and positive from on this side, and you have electric field like this. When we apply a reverse bias means P is connected to the negative terminal and N is connected to the positive terminal. So in the reverse bias, the only current which takes place is the current due to the minority carriers. Now this is the electric field. This electric field was opposing the diffusion current and which created the potential barrier. There is a potential barrier. There is a higher potential on this side, on N side, and lower potential on the P side in the depletion region. Now this potential barrier is further increased in the reverse bias. So the potential barrier was halting the diffusion current, and diffusion current is further stalled by the reverse bias. But what reverse bias does is that there is a drift current. Drift current is because of the minority carriers. In P side, hole is the majority. In the P type, hole is the majority. This is majority carrier and electrons are minority carriers. In the N side, the electrons are the majority carriers and holes are the minority. I am showing minority by small m. Now, the reverse bias voltage, when it is applied, this produces an electric field which aids the crossing over of the minority carriers. Now, these are the minority carriers because the field is in this direction. Originally, that was the field in the depletion region. Because of the reverse bias, it is further increased. So, the minority carriers cross over. And the electrons will cross over like this. Because of the crossing over of the minority carriers, there is a drift current. So please remember, drift current is always because of the minority carriers and diffusion current is because of the majority carriers. So this was just the basic I wanted to cover. Now coming to the breakdown, the Zener breakdown as we call it. Now in the Zener diode, we know that Zener diode is operated in the reverse bias mode, and if we see the voltage and current graph, this side is positive voltage, this is the current we show in milliamperes, and this is on the opposite direction we show in microamperes. Please remember, it is in milliamperes, it is in microamperes. In the forward bias, I have not covered that, but I expect it is known that in the forward bias the graph is like this. But in the reverse bias, there is a very small amount of current which is flowing, which is due to the minority carriers. There is a drift current. This is the knee point, and after that there is a sharp rise in current. So this voltage, we say VZ, beyond this voltage in the negative direction, there is a sharp increase in current. If we say I is equal to VZ upon R. Since the I is very steep, so R is equal to VZ upon I is very low, is very low. Zener diode offers very low resistance in this region after the knee point. Now, how this happens? This happens because of two things. One is the Zener breakdown. Zener breakdown, another is avalanche. Breakdown is the high electric field is created, one because of very thin depletion region and because of very heavy doping. Zener diode is formed by having P and N type semiconductor which are heavily doped. As a result, the depletion region is thin. This region is thin and the electric field in this region is quite high. Now, when the reverse bias voltage is applied, we are connecting this to P side with negative and N side with positive. Because of, as I mentioned, because of the reverse voltage, there is a high electric field in the depletion region. Because of this electric field, there is a rupturing of the electron is taken out from the covalent bonds. So the bonding which is there in the P side, if we take, there is the impurity, and the electrons which are there in the bonds in the crystal, the doped crystal, the electron will be taken out because of the high force exerted by the reverse bias voltage, and as a result, when the electron is taken out in P side, because electric field is operating in this direction, electron will move, the liberated electron moves in this direction and it is collected here. So this happens at a very large scale. There is a large scale rupturing of the bonds because of the electric field, because of the high electric field. So near the depletion region, the rupturing of bond takes place and you have the movement of electrons. So these are the minority carriers in the P side, and whenever the minority carriers cross the junction, there is a drift current. Normally the drift current is slow, like up to this region, but beyond this point the drift current rises extremely fast. It is because of the large scale creation of these minority carriers. Because of the high electric field, the bond, the electron is taken out from the bond. So this is the Zener breakdown. What happens in the avalanche breakdown? In the avalanche breakdown, something similar, but the process by which the minority carriers are made to cross the junction is different. Now let me draw this as a P and N. This is the depletion region I am showing. This is P side, this is N side. This is connected to negative, this is positive, and there is a bias, reverse bias voltage. Now when the voltage increases beyond a point, again there is a rise, sharp rise in current, as in the case of Zener breakdown. In the case of avalanche breakdown also, there is a sharp rise in current, but the process due to which this happens is quite different. Like the electrons are crossing over in this side, the minority carriers, because of the drift current. So these electrons, they acquire enough energy, and this high energy is translated in terms of their velocity, and these electrons which were crossing over because of the reverse bias, these are minority carriers on this side, they are crossing over, and when they are crossing over, they are also colliding, they are moving with high velocity, they are colliding. Like if the electron is moves from this side, it collides with the crystal, the atoms in the crystal, and when it collides, it creates EH pair. E and H pairs are created. So one electron moving with high velocity, with high energy, because of the reverse bias voltage which was applied, because of which it was crossing over, it acquires enough energy to rupture the covalent bond. It ruptures the bond, the electron which is here, it collides with it, it creates E and H pairs are created. When the E and H pairs are created, this now, what is the impact? We have now three conductors. We had one electron moving. This electron collides and it creates E and H, electrons and holes, by rupturing the covalent bond. So you had this original E, one more electron and one hole. Now these further collide with the other crystal atoms in the other on the P side, and they further create E and H. So in the process, large number of electrons are available for crossing over from P side to N side, and similarly large number of holes are available on N side to cross over the junction towards the P side. So this effect, it is avalanche effect, because it is like an avalanche. One electron initially creating E and H pair, further more pairs getting created because availability of one more electron, and crossing over of these minority carriers across the junction, which are now in large number, there is a sharp rise in current. But there is one more difference between the Zener and avalanche breakdown, is that the effect of temperature. In case of Zener breakdown, when the temperature rises, the current also rises, because you have more number of E and H pairs which are available, which can cross over. But in case of avalanche breakdown, when the temperature rises, there are vibrations in the crystal, and because of the vibrations, this energy of the impacting electron gets affected, it decreases, so the avalanche effect is adversely affected by the high temperature. This is another difference between the Zener breakdown and the avalanche breakdown. So that is all about these two types of breakdowns. Thank you.